Hey everybody. Sorry about that. Okay, so I'm showing off my new Warmoth Strat that I just made. Throw on some Jimi Hendrix just because it's a Strat. You gotta pay homage, right? My new Warmoth. Kind of an afterthought. Got all the pieces off Showcase. Pretty much just paid for the paint. Great deal. Everyone's joking about my fetish with green guitars. I never actually specifically thought I liked green so much, but hey, these look pretty awesome. I'll start with the neck, I suppose. Maple on maple, just plain maple. Didn't spring for any quarter sawn or bird's eye or anything like that, but it's a pretty good neck. I'm really liking it. Nothing too fancy as far as wood grain, but looks pretty good. The tuners are just stock from my Squier Telly. They're decent. They're easy to install because they don't have any screws, but there's two little nubs that you kind of had to make holes for in the wood so they don't shift around. They're nice and solid. I got them on there tight. A lot of stuff on this build was just taken from my Squier because it was a budget build. Sometime later on I'll get new pickups and stuff like that for it. The body is alder with a maple top, and I actually really like this quilt top. It's kind of hard to see in this light, but as you turn it, the quilt kind of reflects the light differently. It's really hard to see on this camera, but I'm sure any of you with quilt tops from Warmoth knows how alive these look. You can't really see in picture. Anyway, I can't remember what they call it. I think it's just a green burst top, and with a candy green finish on the back. Just looks kind of plain green until you're really getting close, which you won't be able to do with the camera, but anyway, the pickups are stock Squier. These two here are from my Squier Strat, one of those crappy Indonesian ones. They work, you know, they give you that Strat sound. I'll probably get some Rio Grandes later sometime. This is Duncan designed. It looks like it won't focus there so well. Duncan designed humbucker. Came out of one of those Obey propaganda Telecasters. A friend of mine had one that he replaced with a Fat Cat, and he let me have this humbucker, so worked out pretty good. I just got some black knobs. I don't know how easy they are to see on here. They look nice, but they're a little hard to use because they're so smooth, so you can't really just reach down and turn them too easy. But they work pretty good. Anyway, there it is. Black Pearl Pickguard. The bridge is a Grover. I didn't know Grover made bridges, but I guess they do. And it's actually really good. It's not... I've actually never had the chance to try a Wilkinson or a Hipshot. I hear Hipshots actually are really nice. But I think this was supposed to be designed as a Fender aftermarket piece or something. And it actually works really good. It's nice and tight. I put three springs on it. And I tightened the screws down maybe a little tighter than most people do. But it still has enough. I can dive bomb it. But it's nice and tight. It kind of feels like a hardtail. I'm more of a hardtail guy than a trem guy. But... you know, everyone's got to have Strats, so I've got mine now. I don't think I'll ever need another one. I suppose I'm more of a Les Paul and a Telecaster kind of guy, but anyway. So there she is, my Partsocaster. Someday I'll get some new pickups for it and a new switch, because that switch was crappy Squier, whatever, you know, technology flavor of the week was that year when they made their stuff. So anyway, there she is, my Warmoth Strat. I'll do a playing demonstration tomorrow or something, put that up for you guys too.